Hi, my name is Ivan Nalcera and we're going to explain our group project, the Attitude Indicator or the Artificial Horizon. Let's go! So what is an Attitude Indicator? The Attitude Indicator is a gyro instrument that can inform the pilot its role, pitch, and bank information. Wow, 3-in-1, yummy! This instrument for me is actually important because it gives you the exact information about your airplane's movement. It's like your guardian angel and you are looking at the plane and the sky and the land at the same time. And for you to understand more about this instrument, I'm going to let John Paul Abon explain the operation and indication of the Attitude Indicator. Special thanks to Francis Legaspi for taking his effort in making this wonderful 3D model of an Attitude Indicator. Once again, this is Ivan, and I'll see you again soon.
Hi, I'm John Paul. I'm here today to discuss to you the different indications and operations of an attitude indicator. First, let's have a look at a 3D model of an attitude indicator made by Francis. Before we start, let me briefly introduce to you what is an attitude indicator. An attitude indicator is one of the 6 basic flight instruments found in any cockpit. An attitude indicator, as you can see here, is a traditional round gauge instrument that is driven by a gyro. This type of attitude indicator uses a vacuum or air-powered gyroscope, thus an attitude indicator are vacuum sealed. Now, let's move on to the main topic. Looking at the front view of an attitude indicator, you can see that the tiny horizon bar in the middle, which is color black, represents the aircraft symbol. The white horizontal line going across the middle of the gauge represents the horizon. The white markings in the middle are what we call the reference lines, which indicates the degree of pitch. It may be up or down, that is relative to the horizon. Reference lines, as you can see, have a 10 and 20 degrees of pitch. Next is the top half of the instrument, which is colored in blue, which represents the sky, and the bottom half of the instrument, which is colored in brown, represents the ground. On the other hand, the white markings above the reference line are what we call the bank indications, which have increments of 10, 20, and 30 degrees, as well as 45, 60, and 90 degrees. The pitch is the center point of the aircraft representation. No matter what angle bank the aircraft has, the center dot of the representation will define the aircraft's pitch, which is mainly used whether an aircraft is trying to maintain its altitude in a turn, pitch, climb, or a descent. You can see on the bottom portion of the attitude indicator is where the adjustment knob is located. The adjustment knob is used to calibrate the aircraft symbol if it's not in its proper position. For you to clearly visualize the attitude indicator, let us try and move the attitude indicator. As you can see, if I move the attitude indicator down, it shows that the aircraft is pitching up. While, on the other hand, if I move the attitude indicator up, it shows that the aircraft is pitching down. For you to better understand, let me show you a short clip of an attitude indicator when an aircraft is pitching up or down in an aircraft simulation. Next is when an aircraft is banking to the right or banking to the left. Look at how an attitude indicator is going to move when an aircraft is banking to the right. Next is when an aircraft is banking to the left. See how the attitude indicator is going to move. For you to better understand, let me show you a short clip of an attitude indicator when an aircraft is banking to the right or banking to the left in an aircraft simulation.
Copy Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
Now, let us move to the back side of the attitude indicator. As you can see, this is where the filtered air inlet is located, which is the small hole in the center. For the attitude indicator to work, the air flows through the filtered air inlet through the armature, which is connected to the gyro of the attitude indicator. The air that flows through the filtered air inlet is what causes the gyro of an attitude indicator to spin, thus making this flight instrument work. The vacuum line in is also located on the back side of the attitude indicator. The vacuum in the attitude indicator pulls the air out so that the gyro inside the attitude indicator can spin. And now, my colleague, Lance, will explain to you the works and limitations of an attitude indicator.
Hi, my name is Michael Lance M. Alapap, and today I'm going to discuss about attitude indicator and how it works. So in here we have the attitude indicator. So the attitude indicator is considered as a gyroscopic instrument, because the attitude indicator relies upon a gyroscope to function. So inside the attitude indicator is a gyroscope. So before I explain the attitude indicator, let's talk about what gyro is and how it works. In simplest form, a gyro is a heavily spinning disc that is able to maintain its position and orientation. Gyros operate based on two principles: rigidity in space and precision. Rigidity in space refers to a gyro's ability to remain in a fixed position in the plane in which it is spinning by mounting the gyroscope on a set of gimbal rings. The gyro is able to rotate freely in any direction. Thus, if the gimbal ring rotates, the spinning drive will remain the same plane in which it was originally spinning. The other property of the gyro is known as the precession. The tilting or turning of the rotor axis as a result of external forces. When a deflective force is applied to a stationary gyro rotor, the rotor will move in the direction of the force. For example, if we use the rudders, then the aircraft will yaw, and if we use the elevators, then the aircraft will pitch. So, in short, the gyro's precession will move when there is an external force applied. The external force is the aircraft's rotation due to the primary control surface. X is the disadvantages of the attitude indicator is that The gyroscope needs electricity to function. So, if there is no electricity, then there will be no gyroscope. The attitude indicator will not function. Another is that the attitude indicator gyroscope is so sensitive that when the free rotation is disturbed, the attitude indicator will not work anymore, and it needs a specialist or a mechanic for it to be fully functional again for it to work. That is all. Thank you very much.
So that's the end of our video, and really hope that you enjoyed watching it and learned something about the attitude indicator. Once again, I'm Ivan Alzera, and we're from Section 2C, signing off. Yeah.